Hey, what is up, guys? It is Cherry here from Uncle Cherry the 50 Productions on the Yesteed 2000's channel. Sorry we haven't been posting videos in a little bit. We've been currently redoing the setup. Still not done. Changing some of the ways we film these videos. And so this is a very much work in progress, blah blah blah. You don't need to know any of that. What you do need to know is the topic for today, and it is an interesting one because today was the Galaxy S8 event from Samsung. So what's actually very interesting about this event is that Samsung revealed a product that none of us really expected, and it was the deX or deX dock for your Galaxy S8 phone. Now, smartphones today have been growing more and more powerful. In fact, that a little thing that you can fit in your pocket right here today is about the size of a supercomputer that sent us to the moon. So, they're getting really small and really fast and really powerful really quickly. In fact, I would say the past 3 or 4 years we've been exponentially growing. From 1 to 2, 2 to 4, and now it's gone from 4 to 8, 8 to 16, and all the way to 64. We're just going to keep exponentially growing. The Apple A10 processor is a great example of this. It blows every phone out of the water, number-wise. Here, take this. The Samsung Galaxy S7 and the iPhone 7, and compare the two scores. There's a difference. So what does this new dock do for Samsung? So they're not the first people to come up with this idea. For example, Microsoft last year released a dock for their phone where you plug your phone in and it essentially becomes the full desktop version of Windows 10. The problem with that one is that mobile Windows is probably about 1-2% of the market, and that's being generous. So not a lot of people use Microsoft Mobile, and their store is so small in comparison because they don't have any developers. What Samsung has going for it is that it runs Android, and so the Android store has a lot more apps, and these apps can be used on a desktop experience with ease. Now, I definitely don't think it is perfect. I think that smartphones still have a few years to go before we can really start competing on the computer market. I know Apple the past year has been advertising as their iPad Pro can replace a PC. And to some extent that is true, and I do think the iPad is more likely to replace a PC than a phone can add to a dock at this point. I do think this dock thing is the future. Last week we got a patent from Apple that explained a device where it's like a hollow MacBook shell housing like battery, GPU for the display, those main internals, but the CPU and the storage should all be held natively on the iPhone. So all you would have to do is plug that iPhone in, and now you have essentially a MacBook with better graphic power, better battery life, a bigger screen, where you can do your professional work. And yeah, it won't be adopted by everyone. The professionals are still gonna have those giant ass PCs like I have in the back. But for the average consumer, I could definitely see this replacing their home PC. And imagine if you had one device for everything. When you're on the go, you just take your phone out and use it like a phone. But when you're at home or at work, you can plug that phone into your MacBook shell and do all your typing, and it still be held natively on the iPhone because that's where the storage comes from, and you can access that storage at any point, whether in phone mode or computer mode. Again, I think we are not quite there yet. We're kind of like back here, and the future's kind of like right here, and if this would ever work, we definitely need some new technology first, especially faster processors that can handle more. But I do think we are getting there, and getting there rather quickly. For the past 3 or 4 years, we've been hearing and training ourselves to think that mobile devices are the future, but what if that's only half true? What if mobile devices and desktop-like devices are all one thing in the future? So So it's not exactly like a Surface that's trying to be a tablet and a PC, and then it just kind of ends up not even being a tablet and a really shitty PC. What if it's just one device for one need? And when you need it to be another device, you have to plug that into an external device, but it also holds all the power and storage locally on your first device. Essentially, we would get three devices in one whenever you need them, and it's not the same thing. Because they could be running different operating systems. Your phone could be running macOS when it was plugged into the Mac, and iOS when it was just a phone. This also opens the opportunity that we don't need a single OS for everything, that we can run multiple OSs just depending on the device we use, but again, it's still all connected. Anyway, let me know what you think about this move from Samsung. It's definitely bold, and I'm not sure how it's gonna go, but I will be following this to see how that 1% of people that should buy this like it. Again, I don't think it's quite there yet to replace your PC, but we need these people as stepping stones so that one day in the future, maybe 5 to 10 years, we can actually have a device like this that can really replace the PC from average consumers. Let me know if you're going to pick up an S8 down below or the dock. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Peace out. Later.